With a fresh and clean face, and after I exfoliate and clean my face, I like to go over it with my night relaxing all-in-one cleansing wipe from Clean and Clear. Now normally I use my e.l.f. Cleaning wipes, but I had to go with these for now because I ran out. So these are my backup. So I'm gonna go ahead and cleanse my face and get right into this makeup video. I use my cleansing wipes to cleanse my face. Can't get my words right today. I go in with my oil-free moisturizer, and it moisturizes dry areas and controls shine in oily areas. So I'm gonna go in and moisturize my face before I apply any of my makeup. I'm gonna go ahead and moisturize my lips. They feel a bit dry. Something a tad bit different. Of course, this is the Salon perfect brow pomade, and it is the color dark brown. So I said I was gonna try something a tad bit different this time instead of using my NYX is it dark brown? I think it's a dark brown pencil. So I'm gonna go ahead and try this and fill in my brows. Show you how I get them deep brown. Now I like to start out with the bottom portion of my brows, and then I work my way up to the top. Now I haven't arched my eyebrows as of yet. I actually decided to make a video on how I clean up my eyebrows. So yeah, that'll be in another video. So I just noticed that my camera was not recording. But anyway, the look that we're going for today is the Yandy, her wedding photo. I actually like the hell out the photo, and it is this one. I don't know if you guys can see that. Focus. It's focused, but this is the look that I'm going for today because baby, that makeup was motherfucking on point. Yes, it was on point, and I loved it. So I'm gonna try to recreate this look, and yeah, hopefully you guys like this video. I'm gonna get back to my brows because yeah, you know, doing your brows take forever. You want them deep brows, baby? You craft them, guys. But yeah, this is the look. But I so freaking love her. She is just gorgeous. But anyway, back to these brows. It's okay if you make your brows messy. You're going to eventually go back and clean them up anyway. But unfortunately, I made my left brow darker than my right because I didn't tap off any excess on the back of my hand. So I'm going to try my best to go in to make my left brow lighter just to make them look even because I don't like my brows jet black because that's just not a good look. So these are the two that I use from my LA Girl Pro Concealer. And I use Toast and I use Toffee for my highlight. And I'm going to go ahead and clean under my brows. Normally, I go in with the highlight under my brows. But in the picture, it doesn't look like she has. Well, maybe. A small highlight. So I'm gonna go in with the Toast first and clean under my brows as soon as I can find my pencil brush. I feel like y'all a little bit too close to my face. So as you can see, I'm trying to squeeze the rest that I have out of my tube. But before I do that, let me use my e.l.f. eyelid primer and sheer. I don't know what it is about this primer, but I just love this primer. It is awesome. Same sticky consistency, and it gives a good color payoff if you're using it to, you know, for your brows or for your eyelids or whatever. I'm kind of in a rush, so I gotta hurry. Now when I'm doing my brows, I try to do it as straight as possible because normally I don't go in and I don't conceal or don't clean up the top part of my brow, I just do the bottom. But in this case, I think I'm just going to go ahead and clean up the top as well. And I think on this one, I extended the tail just a little bit farther than what I did on that one. So I'm going to go ahead and fix it. Yeah, you know what I'm trying to say. So while that is on, I'm going to go in with my MilanI banana powder, and I'm going to go ahead and set my highlight. while that's baking and cooking on my damn eyelid, I'm gonna go. So now that my highlight is done baking on my eyes, I'm gonna go ahead and dust that away. So I think I'm gonna have to go in and clean up the top part of my brow. So I'm gonna go in with my MilanI foundation in warm toffee. I'm gonna blind the hell out of you. Go in and use my brush. So after that, I'm going to go ahead and prime my eyes with my eyeshadow base. And I'm gonna go ahead and prime my lid. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use my BH Party Girl After Hour palette. And I'm going to go in with this warm brown color here at the top. And I'm going to put that in my crease. So now I'm going to use my shadow crease dual brush. And this is from Crown Brushes and the number AC0112 brush. And it's a double-ended brush. It's good for getting in those tight spaces like in your crease and to apply your eyeshadow. So now I'm going to go with this because in the picture it looks like she has a very dark outer corner and the lightish like navy blue on the actual eyelid itself. So I'm going to go ahead and use this dark blue at the very top corner right here at the top, at the very outer corner. I try my best to stay, like, not go below my lash line, because I don't want it to go past that. So I'm just doing tapping motions into my outer V. And in hers, it's very sparkly, so I'm going to try to add some sparkle to mine. Best to stay on that outer V. But if you go past the outer V of your eye, you're going to use that color at the bottom of your waterline anyway. But you can also go back with your concealer and clean it up as well. So I figured that outer blue at the top corner was a little bit too light. So I used that blue and the black color down here at the bottom. So all I did was mix the two. And it gave me almost the exact color. Almost. So now that I have it on there in the way I want it, I'm going to go ahead and blend it out along my edges. Just to give it that gradient effect, just to blend in with my transition color. And if you feel like, you know, your transition color was a little washed out or you put too much eyeshadow, you can always go back into the color that you use for your transition and go right above it. So after I apply that, I'm going to go in and wipe my dual brush off. I'm just going to use a piece of tissue to wipe any excess product I have on my brush. So because I want that blue to stand out just a tad bit, I'm going to make my eyelid, I'll add just a little bit more base to the bottom portion of my eyelid because that blue really stands out in her wedding photo. So now I'm going to go in with this shimmery blue color to the portion of my eyelid, the diamond shade. I'm gonna go ahead and blend the two. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and complete my other eye and I'll be right back. So now that my eyes are complete, I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you exactly what colors I use once again. I just use this like salmon type color, off brownish type color for my crease color, and I use this dark blue in the top corner, and I also mix these two together and the black color together. And then for the lid color for the light blue, I just use one of the diamond shades, and I use this color right here. the blue sparkly one. And to go over that, to make it even more, you know, make the sparkle stand out, I use that diamond shade, the pinkish like sparkly shade. So those are the colors that I use on my lids. And I want to give myself a brow bone highlight, but in the photo she does not have one, but I'm gonna go ahead and do it anyway because I think it's cute. So I'm gonna go ahead and get myself a brow bone highlight. So I'm just gonna dip my brush into this goldish type color just a little bit, just a touch. And I'm just gonna lightly brush that over my under eyelid. Under eyelid, that's not even a word. Under eyelid, really? Under my brow. Just to give myself somewhat of an extra highlight. Just to give it the extra glow under my brows. Wow, there we go. Feel like it need a little bit extra. So I'm gonna go ahead and continue the rest of my part of my brows. Just to speed this up a little bit, the rest of the video will pretty much be a voiceover. So you guys can hear my voice. We'll be right back. She funny. She funny. I told her, her mouth, why is she off the chain?
We'll be right back.